as we are commemorating the centenary celebration of the apostolic letter Maximum Illud, the Pope invites all of us through the mission testimonies to make this extraordinary missionary month as the month of remembering the missionary saints. Today, let us be inspired by the missionary spirit of Blessed Paulo Manna. The whole church for the whole world is his motto. Blessed Paulo Manna was born in Italy on 16th January 1872, the fifth of six children. After elementary and technical studies in Avellino and Naples, he continued his studies in Rome. While studying philosophy at Gregorian University, he heard the Lord's call to missionary life and entered the seminary of the Institute for Foreign Missions in Milan, where he completed his theological studies. He was ordained a priest in Cathedral of Milan on May 19, 1894. His superior sent him to Burma in spite of his ill health. He pushed himself tireless dedication in the evangelization and human development of Karen peoples. He was exhausted, his energy drained because of long journey. Malarial fever caught him, and on the onset of tuberculosis forced him to return home on July 7, 1907. This illness could not stop his desire of becoming a missionary. He, in Italy, used his skills and penned down the ardent vision of faith as it is related to the multiple and complex problems of the missions ad gentes. He was later appointed as director of the magazine Le Missioni Cattoliche. He published pamphlets and books and wrote articles on missionary themes that were near and dear to his heart. It was Father Manna in 1915 took the first step towards the foundation of Missionary Union of the Clergy, which Pope Pius XII called the gem of his life. This foundation of Missionary Union of Clergy was praised by the then Pope Benedict XV and expressed his desire that this should be instituted in all the dioceses of the Catholic world. Father Paulo has a strong message for the world, that is, every priest by nature, by definition, is a missionary, but he constantly needs to revive the flame of apostolic zeal in his heart. The missionary is the man of faith par excellence, born of faith, living by faith. For this he willingly works, suffers, and dies. Without faith, the missionary cannot be explained and does not exist. And if he exists, he is not a true missionary of Jesus Christ. Body without a life is dead. Soul without a prayer is dead. Father Paulo says, every missionary's life should be centered around prayer. He says, be men of interior life, men of prayer. It is worth knowing how to preach, but it is worth much more to know how to pray. Preaching will teach about Christ, and the prayer will reveal him. In the year 1924, he was given a responsibility of Superior General of Institute of Foreign Missions of Milan, which later became Pontifical Institute for Foreign Missions. After a decade, in 1934, he also founded New Women's Missionary Community, the Missionary Sisters of the Immaculate Conception. From the year 1937 to 1941, he was made the International Secretary of the Missionary Union of the Clergy. He maintained a network of relationships with apostolic nuncios, bishops, priests from all over the world. In particular, he was very sensitive to the problems posed by the separated brethren. He became a prophet of ecumenism. Father Paolo returned to the eternal home on September 15, 1952. He was beatified by Pope Saint John Paul II.